Hey guys, we're back for game 3 of Rising Stars vs. VG Gaming. This match is the decider. Did I say it wrong?
You said Rising Snake, I believe.
Dang it.
It's okay, it's okay. Gets the best of us. That VG Gaming on the
right. Asterisks. This isn't even.
Oh my god. Yeah, I mean, Rising Asterisks. You don't know. Rattlesnake on the Dire, with Lifeslayer being banned out, and Nyx Assassin bat on the Radiant. The winner will go on and face, I do believe, LGD China.
Yeah.
And the loser will be facing
that other one.
The other one. Rising Balls, Rising Snake, Rising Stars. Rising Stars on the.
Just keep guessing until.
Just, 5 seconds. Just insert terms until we get there. But Shadow Demon is going to slip through one more time. We saw Kunga doing a ton of work here. I'm somewhat surprised that Rattlesnake did not ban it out. And they're going to go with the same pickup here. Darkseer as well as Clockwork. For what's worth, I thought they did pretty well in the bot lane. They weren't picked off. Even against the Shadow Demon gang, they were getting a ton of EXP. They had some two-man jungle pattern with the Iron Shell in the jungle, and they were stacking it as well.
Yeah, that was pretty cool.
Yeah.
I feel like that dual lane has been used a lot against melee heroes. Do you think they would be better off if they just laned ranged something against them, like a ranged carry, like Luna? I mean, Luna's not very popular right now, but it commonly is laned versus the Darkseer. And
just
They don't care. They're just going for the same stuff, Spectre and Akunka. With the Shadow Demon.
If it ain't broke, don't need to fix it. So, I mean, there's just saying, show us something else. I mean, this is not where you... I guess you could go something like Puck or Storm and try to initiate against them, but there's just so much HP, right? Storm, generally one of his benefits is to jump in on one of your support, preferably, and you just pull and just going to work. It really doesn't work against Shadow Demon Disruption. It definitely does not work against Kokorum, making them survive twice as long.
Uh-huh.
So it hurts initiation power heroes like Clockwork. It hurts your Darkseer. Where do you go from here? I don't think you could take a game where you could try to burst down people because of Kokorum.
Yeah, it really does change the game a lot and how all the ganks really work in the Chinese scene. Because it's always very, very crisp little ganks that go off if you guys watch them.
Right.
One hero will shift over. You don't want to give it overkill because you want the perfect amount, because that would be wasted hero resources that you could be spending other places, making your carry safe or ganking other lanes. So it's very precise amounts of damage, and if you can delay a gank, it usually almost always swings fights.
Yeah, especially with how quickly people TP in the Chinese games.
Yeah.
It definitely is a big deal. We're going to see Gyrocopter for the first time today here being picked up. I think one of the stronger carry in this patch because how games kind of have the propensity to go very quick, like it's decided 15, 20 minutes in.
Uh-huh.
You want a carry to have a high impact, but if the game does go up late longer, your flat cannon takes you to late game. So he's a great laner. He wins mostly every solo lane. And we'll see how it goes here. We're going to see Shaker and Lone Druid ban out respectively for both teams. And yeah, so far so good.
How do you feel about a Gyrocopter versus a late game Spectre? Because Gyro does do a lot of AoE damage, so hypothetically, if he has some good damage items, he could clear Spectre illusions relatively fast. Probably not fast enough to actually kill them, but I just feel like he has to have a BKB 100%, because Spectre will rip him apart in melee range with Rocket Barrage and Dispersion and Desolate and everything, so.
I agree, yeah. Spectre is one of the few carries, melee carry wise, that doesn't actually go Basher. I mean, she can, but I don't think she will. And generally, when one of the best way to deal against Gyrocopter we've seen is like a Basher Bear or Anti-Mage going in with a Abyssal and just kill him very quickly. Because if you trade man hits, like the carry himself probably will survive, but your supports won't. Because they would just get flagged down. So maybe if the supports get themselves like Four Staff slash Gold Scepter, then they will. But if this goes long enough, I think Gyrocopter might actually out-carry a Spectre.
He certainly can out-farm him, I would say, in the early game.
Sure,
Spectre
yeah.
kind of becomes a farming monster for the fact that, number one, he doesn't have to be at fights immediately. You don't have to TP to lanes until things happen. You use your ulti, and then you teleport in. And number two, his farm rate can be pretty nice when you grab a Radiance, which isn't always the case. Diffusal Blade with Mantis style in the previous game worked out quite nicely. So.
I think against the Darkseer again that she's not going to be going for the Radiance build.
Yeah, probably not.
Another added benefit is that she's somewhat tough to gank. I mean, you send a three-man gank party, it's very easy for her to send a dagger into the trees.
Yeah.
And you just walk away. You're fairly tanky with things like your early drums and phase, as well as your dispersion. So.
Yep. You can also teleport to, or you can use your ulti.
Sure.
And teleport to an enemy in a different lane. It's usually what I do when I get ganked. I'm like, oh, there's three heroes. See you later.
Run away, yeah.
I don't care if I lose a couple waves of EXP. It's way better than dying. Dying is not fun.
Although the way that the VG Gaming has been using their haunts, or like just haunting whenever they can, they're using their haunt like drum charges, which they just drink through very quickly. We're going to see Juggernaut as the fourth pickup here. And the scary thing for me is that you have Healing Ward plus Cocoa Worm, and so far there isn't any good way to kill the Healing Ward. Like, if you micro well enough, you have a 350 range hero. I guess Surge helps out with that.
Yeah.
But I feel like you need like a 600 range support or a carry that could kill the ward very quickly.
Yeah, the best are like Venomancer. Venomancer is so good at killing the Healing Ward.
Just drop your own wards and target it?
Yeah. I mean, here comes Resurgence of Venomancer. I'm predicting this. No, I'm just kidding. It's not going to happen. But Silencer is quite ranged. This is going to shut down some of the combo. I think the main reason that they grabbed Silencer here and why we probably saw banned last game, I didn't make the connection before, but I watched an IXDL game at one point, and there was a Silencer drafted against the Spectre. And what you do is you wait until Spectre ulties, and as soon as Spectre ulties, Silencer uses Global Silence. And because he does that, it prevents the Spectre from using Reality. So basically, Spectre can't show up to the team fight. And if he uses his ulti and it's countered, he has to TP.
He has to play like a regular carry at this point. He doesn't have that free car to come in a team fight.
And that's going to hurt his farm. And what the player I was watching was Liquid TC's stream at the time. He had to get a pretty fast Manta. That way, as soon as the Global Silence was applied,
he would have to Manta out of the fight and then haunt in.
He would Manta out of the Global Silence and then haunt into the team fight, which basically left his illusions behind, but he was still at the fight.
Yeah, that's...
So they might have to do something really wacky like that.
I mean, it also gives you a ton of other added benefits. For example, if you see Kunkka X, you last word him, or you last word him, and then he X and he silences himself. He can't taunt. Same thing with Shadow Demon. You last word him, he disrupt, and he can't follow up with this other spell. So it's not just really good against Spectre. It has a ton of other added benefit as well. Talked about needing them a 600 range hero. Well, he sort of does that, and he will be looking to kill Healing Ward. So, a very, very good support pickup. But at the same time, oh my god, we're going to see ourselves a Doombringer. Rattlesnake actually picks up Doom very commonly. They run it solo mid as well. I just don't know how he matches up against CTY's Kunkka. In fact, I think he gets kind of stomped in that lane.
There's so many weird heroes going on. Not only just like the Kunkka Spectre, but also it's probably going to be an aggressive Juggernaut, Leshrac, Shadow Demon Trilane, right? Unless they're doing duels, which is a possibility. Maybe it's like three solo lanes and then a dual roam of Leshrac, Shadow Demon. That's a possibility. But even if that's the case, Spectre is not a very strong solo hero, honestly. Like, if anything, they might do the same dual lane aggressive Darkseer Clockwork. And if that's the case, Spectre could definitely get solo killed. So
yeah, I think because they recognize that that's a possibility of the clock Darkseer offlane, I think they're going to just do Juggernaut solo top.
I think it'd be okay.
Yeah, I see he's going to win that lane, but you're going to be able to spin him away from the lane and get some CS. Maybe get a Bottle Crow going on, and then you have the support of a Leshrac, and then you still run your Kunkka SD mid, because I don't think Doom gets any farm if that's the case.
And Doom could jungle if he wants to. We'll see what they do for starting item builds, but...
Yeah, so jungle Doom is actually, like, a myth.
What do you mean a myth?
Like... You hear it happening, you think it works, but it just like...
Okay, I just did it 4 hours ago, 5-6 hours ago, I jungled Doom.
Did you play against Vichy Game?
I did not. Okay. So, playing jungle Doom against good players,
does not work.
Not the best. The way that it works, basically, it's highly chance-based, first of all, which is not a good situation to be in a high-level competitive environment. And number two... Hopefully nobody touches you for a long time.
For like 5-6 minutes.
More than 5-6 minutes. Like
really?
You have to grab a Dark Troll Warlord to spawn skeletons, or you have to grab a Tornado Wildkin Creep
and start stacking camps, like a champ. Yeah.
And then you kill the stack camp. So before you kill the stack camps, you're like level 2, and it sucks. If you don't get a Wildkin or a Dark Troll, you're gonna have a bad time.
So what if you get like a Furball Clap or something? Then you just like
You can't cast it. You can cast it once, and you do like 150 magic damage. Big deal. So basically, you need one of those two creeps to effectively jungle Doom.
Well, what Luo's going to be looking for, I've seen him actually go solo mid on the Darius side before.
Yeah.
He basically just give up the first wave. He starts out in the jungle, and he looks for the big Satyr creep, which gives him 4 HP regen per second, which is actually really
it's
legit.
4 now.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, it combined with his base HP, it adds up close to 4. If you think about it, your first wave that you give up, which I questioned last time because he was up against a Quap. But this time he's up against a Kunkka. Maybe he could get a little bit better, but you're still dealing with zero armor. You're still going to get harassed the hell out by that Tidebringer. So I'm not sure whether it's actually the right thing to do to give up your first wave, but I think that's what he'll end up doing.
It could be worth it, honestly. There's other creeps that you can try to snag early if possible. Luckily, the Satyr creep not only gives you all the HP regen, but EXP as well is really fantastic. Like, it's a level 6 creep. If you want better abilities, you can grab the small Dark Troll High Priest or something.
Yeah,
it's pretty rare, but it gives you 2 mana per second aura, which is a mat. That's like a level 4 CM aura by you. And you can also cast a heal on yourself, so... it's not a whole bunch of heal, but it's pretty cool. And let's go over the players quick. For the Radiant team, this is Team Vici Gaming, currently tied 1-1 with Rattlesnake. CTY is playing Kunkka. This is the aggressive tri-lane, apparently. Fenrir playing Shadow Demon. Fi playing the Leshrac. And we've got ZSMJ playing Spectre once again. And the last player that I'm missing is XTT on the Juggernaut.
So very interesting item build coming out here. CTY is going for a Gauntlet first. That will delay the bottle. He's saving 200 gold still. XTT, though, boots the speed first, as well as a little bit of pull regen. They want to get that first blood. They want to get XTT a little bit of experience advantage. And against Gyrocopter, like, if you get the jump on him, he's dead. He does have fairly high base movement speed at 315. So it's somewhat of a difficult pickoff. Of course, this is game number 3. The winner gets to go to the winner bracket facing against LGD. Loser will be playing against Rising Star tomorrow. Meanwhile, on the dire side, we're going to have Kabu going mid here. So Kabu played support clock last game, and now they're going to switch up a little bit. We're going to have Luo Doom. Is this a top lane solo Doom? Yes, in fact it is. And we're going to see offensive trialing featuring a Dark Seer being handled by Lam, Icy's Gyrocopter, and Sagam Neo on Silencer. If you ask me what synergy this lane have, I cannot tell you, because the hell does this lane do? Surge into Rocket Barrage?
They could Iron Shell Rocket Barrage for melee magic damage, which is almost kind of cool, but Gyro's a little squishy. His base armor isn't too bad at 4, but it's definitely a really, really weird lane. Compare this to Spectre, Leshrac, Shadow Demon. I mean, it's not even close. They could set up kills quite easily. They would have to worry about magic damage output, because again, Rocket Barrage is an insane amount of single target damage. It does 330 magic damage at level 1, so hypothetically speaking, if they do catch a hero solo, they could kill them. But
yep,
it might be a bit until we see that.
Well, it's going to be a dual lane that they're going to be facing up against. Flat Cannon will be driving ZSMJ out of lane, and they're actually pushing this lane quite effectively as well. I think he's trying to hit level 2. Is he going to get level 2? No. I thought what they wanted to do is drop the Iron Shell and immediately push into tower, give level 2 on Icy, and just go for the kill with the Rocket Barrage. But instead, they're going to be doing a little bit of creep skipping, perhaps. Yes, in fact, they will. Rattlesnake now pulling this first wave into the neutral creep and basically farming both of them with Flak and Iron Shell. This is really smart coming up from Rising Rattlesnake. And that is the synergy. You creep skip, you Flak Cannon, and you basically starve the Spectre, who is tanking a ton of tower damage as a result. Very, very kind of creative way to lane this.
He did get a poor man shield at the start, so this isn't the end of the world for him, but he actually only has 2 levels of Tango, or 2 Tangos left over. Leshrac only 1, so pretty shortly here, this is going to cost him a whole lot. And Shadow Demon shifting over. He also has absolutely 0 HP regen. He was sitting mid to try to help Kunkka with the dual lane, but now Clockwork has a slight level advantage because he sat there earlier, and it's going to cost him a bit.
He actually had a Tango to start out, and if you look at CTY, he gave them the Tango, so I'm not exactly sure why he did, because he definitely needed regen on the bot lane. A little bit of dewarding board goes on. Seems like Dire has won that one. And again, the name of this game is on the bot lane to pressure, and so far they're doing an excellent job doing it. Meanwhile, top here, it's going to be a Doom versus a Juggernaut. Doom's going to be devouring away, and you know, he's actually doing a fairly decent job harassing XTT, who went for a 0 stat build since he got boots first.
And he actually doesn't have a stout shield either, so every right click that Doom puts on him is really big. The only downside is that he grabbed an early Centaur creep, which gives an attack speed aura to his creeps, which means that his wave is pretty much always going to be pushing here.
Right, maybe he's going to switch creeps a little bit. Unfortunately, he's going to find himself another Centaur. Maybe someone disappointed. We'll eat it still. Back in the mid lane, though, looks like we have a little bit of a... harassing back and forth. Kabu with the double damage rune, gone for a solo kill attempt, not gonna find it. I imagine he's gonna be leveling up his Clockwork Battery Assault to give him a lot more solo killing opportunities as the lane progresses.
There's a high troll creep.
Oh, mid lane here, CTY is looking for Torrent, animation canceling, back and forth, oh, he's gonna run into it, Torrent splash off to the creeps, one more hit, the cog's gonna come through, get that last kill, he does. Is he gonna get the top? Yeah, the creeps are on the aggro, okay. This is where he said Worf. Well played. Shadow Demon, meanwhile, gets a rebuttal kill on the bot lane. What a player, CTY.
Takes out the Gyrocopter on the bot. perfect hero to jump on. Apparently Silencer was not able to do a whole lot in this lane setup. No surprise there. Silencer and a tri-lane, man. What is going on?
I mean, generally that's how they run it as a support Silencer, but normally he started in the early game doing nothing but pulls. You don't expect him to roar out the gates with a ton of harass or damage output. It just doesn't work really well.
And the mid matchup is back together again. Actually, great cog here. Puts Kunker right inside with him. He's doing level 2 battery assault. This is a lot of damage, actually. Will he throw the Tauring? Cancels it. He's just going to die to the battery assault. So a little bit overly optimistic there. I would like to say, though, that cog was really long distance. Like, it looked like he was trying to use it just to kind of harass, but
yeah,
it actually caught him inside of it.
I mean, sometimes you just get a freebie like that, and Kabu says, okay, this is the reason why you want to level up Battery Assault, at least to get the second level. Your damage output just increased by a ton. Now he's level 6. If he wants to get a TP, he could massacre that trialing on the bot. Meanwhile, though, we did see Dragonite making a long foray through the jungle. Looks like he got a pull, and will be farming that in front of his tower.
The bot tri-lane's still pressuring, doing some tower damage. Actually, they've got a Ring of Basilius, so pushing is going to be a bit easier. There's the first disruption. Here comes the level 2 stun. It is actually going to whiff, and the surge for Gyrocopter. He gets out completely. Even a Curse of the Silent on the two supports and the illusions, so that's going to cost him a rocket even hitting, so they are going to get quite low. Even ZSMJ running for his life takes some more flat cannon, one tango.
I mean, they were doing okay in that tri-lane since they got a silencer kill, but you cannot make these kind of... They didn't even get a silencer kill. They got a gyrocopter kill, excuse me. You cannot make these kind of unforced errors. Like, I think they could have maybe grabbed another one, but now that they missed, Shadow Demon has to walk all the way back to base since he's out of mana, and they're basically sitting ducks to that curse, as well as any kind of physical harass. If Rattlesnake wants to make that big push, or kind of Iron Shell and Flat Cannon, they definitely can, and basically push ZSMJ out of EXP range.
So the Doom in the meantime is at level 6 now. He's going to continue eating creeps. He grabs the Satyr one, so 4 HP regen per second. Most likely won't use Shockwave offensively, but with the phase up, he doesn't have to worry that much about dying to the Juggernaut now, because the spin, he can actually just get away from it.
Yep. Shadow Demon's going to TP back. They're going to be looking for a quick pick right now, because you generally don't want to stay in this lane too long. You're taking a little bit of pot shot from the Flak. You're taking a little bit of pot shot from the Curse. And it looks like Silencer is out of position and dropping a ward now that they don't know that, so... They don't really have a safe goal yet. Block will cook. Did I hear it on the mid lane? Yeah. No, he didn't.
A little bit of trading from CTY there. He threw a torrent from high ground when there was no vision from the clock. And then he walked into melee range and traded hits a bit. But at that point, he's pretty much out of managing damage potential. And he can trade hits a slight amount, but it's just a little scary, honestly.
It looks like Juggernaut was actually forced to go all the way back to base. He picked up level 6. He's looking for a TP on the bot lane to set up a kill or maybe mid. Generally, you don't want to walk all the way back to base. In fact, he is looking for a TP. It should be completely obvious to Rattlesnake that, hey, Juggernaut's been missing for a long, long time. And in fact, they're not going to get the kill. They also have ward set up. They will see XTT roaming by, so a ton of time being wasted here by XTT.
Yeah, it kind of makes it a bit obvious when the Shadow Demon goes that aggressive, because they haven't showed the hard carry in a bit or the Juggernaut, so they say, okay, well, if Shadow Demon's trying to set something up, obviously they want us dead, and they're just going to sit really far back with the same tri-lane still. Level 4 Gyrocopter, level 4 Darkseer, and the level 3 Silencer.
Yep. They kind of see the Juggernaut running past towards the mid lane, so they will try to get into EXP range for a bit, and eventually they'll see XTT running back. So, I mean, he's, in a sense, he's not doing a lot, but also on the flip side, he's keeping people back just by his presence missing on the minimap. But as a result, though, Doombringer is just going ham on those creeps on top.
He is pretty good at farming. So, actually, maxing out Scorched Earth first, 2 levels of Devour.
Very interesting.
Yeah, you don't really need to max out Devour anymore. It does decrease the cooldown between each cast, which means it increases your GPM if you max it first. But I personally really like Scorched Earth a lot. The duration is decent, and the damage and regen over time are fantastic at 30. So this is actually a decent damaging spell. Stun's going to land for once on the bot lane on Silencer, and he should be right-clicked. They try to save the gold for the Spectre, but he doesn't get it. And we actually see a Doom on the Jug. I'm sure he would have loved to use his ulti here, but just a simple right-click. And actually, they tried to deny him. Not helping out. The boat comes through. Torrent's going to land, though, on top of Luo. More right-clicking. He might go down. He does go down. The Surge not able to save him.
ZSMJ could last creeps. Can it last at allies? Disappoint.
Did you see Leshrac throw the
attack? Yeah, Leshrac threw one now. I think he was expecting ZSMJ to help out as well.
He was at, like... I don't know, 3 hits or something.
Yeah.
He throws one out and doesn't get denied as a result. We see a disrupt. Are we going to see an X? Yes, it's actually a level 3 torrent. ends up landing through. The chase comes. He surges away. Big curse actually on top of these guys. And even C2Y taking a ton of right-click damage. He pops his last bottle charge. Iron Shell damage being done as well, and he's running for his life. Flag Cannon, 10 HP. Clockwork kills Spectre, actually. And this dive is costing
Big Rockets
a lot.
Big Rockets. Rockets cooling down about... Rockets ready to go. Where's the Rockets? CTY's low. He's...
Come on, man. Oh,
I hear it.
It's going the wrong way.
What?
That's the complete opposite side of the map. He's actually just checking for a rune, so he looks just greedy. Super greedy.
No, Super Greedy would have fired it to the bot lane, got a kill, and that would have been the place.
Not greedy when you win all the time, right?
I mean, Kabu knew a rune was spawning because he had bot rune vision.
He should have flown it over the rune spot while killing ZSMJ. It's
there,
the only,
exactly.
It's the only way it would have been okay in your eyes, I guess.
That wasn't a 420 play. I mean, that's all I'm saying.
I'm sure he's going to work hard to appease you now.
To improve that 420-ness. I agree. XCT now still level 6. Got Doom, got killed early, and wasn't able to pick up too much EXP. I mean, we definitely see the power of a well-farmed Juggernaut in game number 1 when he got things like Manta, Butterfly, and he was just carrying very hard. And we might see a very unfarmed Juggernaut, and to be honest, I don't think he does much.
You don't think Juggernaut does much as a hero?
Unfarmed Juggernaut.
Oh.
Like the way that he's level 6, he's running a map, he's not really doing much.
Alright, I would say that he can aim for heroes like Gyro. Gyro is still really low HP, doesn't even have a drum or a... He's got a wand for HP, basically. So an Omni Slash right now actually will do pretty decent damage to the Gyro. So I think he should aim for Gyro, and then follow it up with a spin afterwards, chase him down, try to kill him. Other squishy heroes, Silencer. So it's like Silencer and Gyro, those are your targets. I mean, Omni Slash, if you can help use it to burst people down, it could be huge. So.
Well, looks like he's not going to be bursting anybody down just yet, as we see Rattlesnake looking to pressure a little bit tier 1. I'm still not sold on this build, not to max Devour. Like, the cooldown does increase, but so does the goal you gain also increase, right? So.
Yeah, I think the reason he's just not maxing out is because he wants more level deaths, and it will make him stronger in the mid game. What I've found with Doom, I've gone like a max Devour, max Scorch Earth build. You just kind of become like a walking, burning target that
yeah, you don't do
doom,
anything.
And that's about all you can do in the early game. And he has a lot of movement speed right now, so I'm sure he'd much rather have the ability to nuke if possible.
Fenrir's going to get hooked right now on the bot lane. He's looking for the self-disrupt. Torn, as well as the bow, will eventually follow through. Kabuto really has no backup. He's going to die. Word house the rest of the team. Looks like Doom was able to get a Doom on ZSMJ, but looks like it's going to be a slow on top of him. He gets surged back out. The cooldown's going to hit everybody. That's one kill. Healing Ward's going to come through as well. Where's the flat cannon? That's going to be a second kill. There's an Omni Slash hitting on the Haunted Illusion. No, that was the SMJs. Are they going to hunt back in a teamfight? Surge getting him back out. Man, Icy's going so quick that he could draw a picture on the ground. No, unfortunately not. Dark Sarah's going to go down as a result.
He lands so many of his torrents, it's insane.
Jesus.
That was, man, torrent after torrent. And Rattlesnake is running for their lives. They're going to go back and heal the Doom as well as the Gyrocopter are now both low. It's a Bracer for Gyro, so most likely going to be a Drum. And Doom is picking up. Nothing new, just drums.
Yep.
He's really fast now.
Who do you thought came ahead in that last team fight? I mean, we saw ZSMJ dying.
And it was a lot of deaths on both sides, it seemed like. Vici did get to chase them away at the end, so technically they're the victors. Does that work? Does that count?
I mean, they defended the tier 1. Dooms wasn't effective. They were able to kill the solo mid Kabu that was initiating. ZSMJ died, though. And, of course, Gyrocopter was able to pick up a couple kills. It was pretty messy, so I'm not exactly too sure who came out ahead of myself.
Yeah, I'm really not sure either. Let's look at the graphs, at least, to try to get some understanding. More or less zero and more or less zero. So I guess that didn't really help a lot.
It's a pretty even... I mean, it went upwards. I guess it was a dire advantage, maybe a bit, but... Yeah, Gyrocopter kind of getting the better end of the exchange, I suppose. Quick item check on ZSMJ. Looks like a drums is flying out. Not a completed one, but...
Ooh, X as well as the Torrent. Man, he's even going to throw a boat on. The Torrent actually whiffs completely, but the boat's going to land on top of him. Split Earth lands as well. There's the Silencer ulti. They're right-clicking. The Doom is on top of Juggernaut, so that's going to prevent him from actually getting out of here completely. And he gets killed, so only one. Oh, great hookshot, actually. This is really bad for C2Y. He's going to get cogged in as well, and the battery's still Rocket Barrage. Immediate death for Kunkka here on the mid lane. And Rattlesnake reacting to that extremely well.
Look at this build coming out from Lamb. He's going for wall at level 6. No single point of vacuum. He's just straight up up walling on top of Kabu's cog. So there's just so much, like, I guess expectation as well as respect for Clockwork just initiating like that.
I mean, if somebody's cogged in and you can put the wall on top of them, it's really good. Because right. if the illusion keeps dying, the wall of replica will spawn a new one. They'll take another 150 magic damage, and their illusion will continue to beat on them. So, hypothetically speaking, it makes you pretty decently strong in the early game Darkseer, because a low-level vacuum really doesn't do them much anyways. The radius is kind of small. You'll get a mini stun out of it, but in terms of damage potential or really pulling the team together, I don't think it matters that much.
Yeah, it somewhat surprised me, because you're not really needing a big illusion of steel. The nuke damage isn't exactly insane. It's 150 damage nuke, which you'll get at... Well, not exactly from vacuum, because vacuum has a very low damage spell, but... Yeah, it's something different, and so far it's working out decently. We also saw the first global in the mid lane, which I didn't think was really the most effective use of the global, and it's cooling down right now.
Yeah, it seems like kind of a weird situation to use it in. Like, didn't it seem like they had already cast all their major spells before?
Yeah, pretty much. Or they were on the run, so it's just like, okay.
And his defense, though, sounds are just to have that kind of foresight must be really tough. Disruption, Soul Catcher as well. Here comes a possible stun. Torrent's going to land boat as well. Man, this guy likes throwing boats. I mean, that's overkill, but it's got 50-second cooldown or something
crazy.
Yeah,
it's like, I mean, you run faster to the creeps.
Seconds.
You can't even fault him. He's like, I see creep wave mid. Boat for that. No problem.
Boat for this, boat for that, boat everything.
Well, back in the top lane here, we do see a tier 1 tower push from Vichy Gaming. Speaking of which, these tower pushes, very, very big deal for the supports, because they definitely need some gold. Meanwhile, on the bot lane, ZSMJ is going to eat a rocket to the face. Are they going to be making that dive? Tier 1's low clockwork is going to fly right in here. And this is going to be... Oh my god, Global's going to come through. They're going to get the kill. 4-5 TP is going to come in. Finra's low. Finra's going to purge. He's going to go picked off here. And where's XTT? He's going to be actually micro... He needs to micro that war. Somebody targets it. They do two-man Torrent. My god, CT-wise landing some beautiful ones. And now Luo's juking back and forth for the kill. FY, oh, he does hit the splitter, but the slow animation is going to mean he's going to go down as a result. XTT's on the run, and that big level death, he doesn't max devour for this. The X is going to find him. The Stomp's going to come through as well. And the Kunkka's could turn around for Sag-M. Sag-M really was low HP there.
Yeah, that was a really nice play. I can't believe the Clockwork Hook landed. He must have rocketed him first or something like that, but initiated on the Spectre, and the Spectre gets doomed immediately. They just completely shut him down and wanted to make sure that he wasn't going to survive that fight, and they did that. So, what do you think's Doom's building right now? He's got an Ogre Club. It's either a Heaven's Halberd, an Aghanim's, or a BKB. I'm guessing it's going to be a BKB, because we've seen so many Black King bars so far from the Asian teams. What do you think?
Yeah, I mean, it you still get purged and all that stuff, but... It makes you so intimidating. The support simply have to run from you. It's gonna be very surprising if it's not gonna be a BKB.
Sanjin Yasha, Doombringer. He needs that extra agility. His armor is really low.
I'm gonna guess Heaven's Halberd before Sanjin Yasha. Heaven's Halberd against, for example, Spectre or Kunkka is still a real thing.
That is true.
Next thing we know, we might see a caster Doom. You know, that could happen.
Yeah, it could. I always want to build Heaven's Halberd a lot earlier. It's always so cool, but I always feel like I get it way too late. Like, it's the third or fourth item.
Well, I'm going to see a tier 1 destroy up top. That's going to get picked up by Lashrek.
Hopefully, they'll buy a first item Halberd now. It's the only way that this will make. It'll be better this way.
He's got Sanj gold. So far, he's not been picked up
any. That's
cool. That's cool.
Buy it. Just buy it.
No Sanj being picked up. I dislike the global on the bot lane. I think after they doom the Spectre, you don't need a global on her to make sure she's silenced. I believe she's silenced after the doom. So they kind of wasted the global to me, because everybody TPing. The global happened during the duration of those TPs, and it didn't do anything.
I guess so, but it's kind of a panic thing. Maybe he didn't know that the doom was going to doom. Like,
sure,
maybe the communication wasn't there. Because he was cogged in. If you're cogged in, and you're worried about him, like, rifting to this position, and the cogs are here, and you could just get out of the cogs immediately, it could mean an escape. You never know. Maybe he was going to, like, dagger right and just absolutely escape. Could have been a lot of things that were happening there.
Well.
So. But yeah, I'm sure that'll help their team fight a lot if they do actually get those little small things worked out.
Yeah, Global's one of those spells to me that if you use it properly, it wins a team fight single-handedly. But at the same time, if you don't, then... It's just a big do-nothing spell that costs a ton of mana. So.
Yeah. I've seen stuff like that before. If you don't use it effectively, then yeah, it's going to cost you quite a bit. And it is such a big cooldown as well. 140 seconds means that you definitely need to use it at the right time.
Well, we're gonna quickly check out in terms of item progression. Luo's gonna be going for still nothing. Did he complete his drums? No, he didn't, because he's had it for
Which
a while.
Which are you talking about?
Yeah, Doom.
Yep,
he does. Still sitting at 15.
Definitely Sanjin Yasha.
I don't know, man. He had a very good opportunity to pick up that Sanjin Sanjin base.
Someday.
Yep. Lam's going to be going for a Buckler on a support Darkseer, which I'm surprised that the clock didn't go for it. I feel like having an early mech, especially against all this burst damage coming out from Radiant, is very, very good, but seems like he's going to be going for either a BKB or could be going for like a CTY Acceptor like he did last time.
Hmm. Acceptor is really good though.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
It will put your ulti down to a very low cooldown, so you can kind of just hop in and out of battle. You can use your stun multiple times in teamfights.
Yeah.
And both teams are just kind of ramping up to maybe initiate. Shadow Demon sitting a little back, but he's going to get spotted up by the rocket. So they're a little scared that the enemy team is in this area at the moment, but they're actually all sitting mid. It's kind of a little bit of a standoff for both teams.
No,
and they will smoke, so a little more future scene or whatever.
Wow, you're really tired.
Thank you.
Looks like I'm smoking around looking for that kill. Tier 1 tower is nearby here. I don't really think you should take this fight, but they do have global though, so if they cog one and wall on top, that's a... Oh, Finrod's just not moving. There's going to be Clockwork Hook. There's a global just right on time. Call down, not going to hit. The Doom comes in against CTY as well. They want to make sure that he... Oh, no. Wow. Curse Doom. Oh, he's going to be dead for sure. Healing Ward's going to get destroyed. CTY runs back in. He's dead. BKB up on IC, and they're going to be chasing a Luo. Luo has Invis, but he gets Omni Slash. Did he just try to Shadow Blade?
Yes, he did. He Shadow Amuleted.
Oh, man. Well, we did get an answer of what he's going to be going for. It's Ogre Club into Shadow Blade. Now, looks like they're going to be on a full retreat. CTY buying back out, but not finding anything.
A dagger's gonna go low ground. That's a blind shot. It's gonna miss though. So Spectre shifts back towards the mid lane. Still doesn't have his Diffusal Blade finished. Yeah, Doom's level death. He got really lucky with the leveling. He doomed the Kunkka, I believe, and then he level death him immediately. And he got the bonus damage, which is a huge percentage, by the way. They take 20% of the target's maximum health. So, a lot more damage than it did.
Really?
Pass Clockwork looking for a combo. Boat's gonna land. Dagger comes through as well, but they still can't finish him off. Leshrac's able to do it, though. Just stays on the outside. And ZSMJ actually does end up getting stopped. He is blocked, and can anyone kill this? Oh, there's one tank on Shadow Demon, and Splitter's just gonna do it, so.
Yeah, that was a pretty big trade for them in the mid lane. It was 2-2, CTY bought back, but they ended up getting another kill as well as a tier 1 on the mid lane. And, I feel like Vichy Gaming... I think it's fair to start talking about kind of if it goes late game, who has advantage and whatnot. On one side, you have Gyrocopter, who's having a pretty big game. He's 8-2-4. He's got an early BKB, still 9-second charges. He's hitting a decent level. His teammates are stacking for him. There's also a Doombringer who's going to be going for Shadowblade, getting that initiation build up. I'm just not sure whether to get out carry a Spectre, a Kunkka, and to a certain extent, a Juggernaut, who's fairly underfarmed.
I'm not sure he's going to carry either, but the Shadowblade's going to help Doom out a lot. If he wants to initiate on some of the key heroes, he can. I don't know if Spectre is necessarily the right choice. I think actually jumping on the Kunkka is pretty good, just because if he gets his boat off, we talked about how good the rum is, but the magic nukes spread across all of Rattlesnake can really add up quickly, so shutting him down is possible, but the downside is he's not that squishy, so your timing window of killing him before he is able to cast his spells, it's much harder.
Yeah, I mean, last time I think he had a little miscue. He actually walked back in teamfight and got picked off. Also, I'm not sure whether you want to use Global and then Doom immediately. Maybe you could actually just wait a second or two and just take advantage of your full... Like you said, when he started to get Tanker and Tanker, every second of silence matters. Back in the mid lane here is DSMJ. This is kind of the beauty when you have a Shadowblade Kunkka build, is that you suddenly become... You basically have like a free revenge on your team, it feels like. It just... Every time he finds a target... X-Torn, mm-hmm. Invis, X-Torn. It's just hard for people to actually find a safe place anywhere. Unless you're traveling in packs with tier 3.
Well, Leshrac is pushing the bot lane a bit. Wants to finish up a mech. Gyro's going to get down here and defend this. He does have his BKB finished, so being dived on by the Spectre is not that big of a deal. And it's a Blade of Alacrity, so possible Diffusal Blade. Most likely Diffusal Blade into Manta style is what we'll see out of him.
Manta might not be too bad out of this game. You talked about the... necessity to manta the silence from global and then being able to haunt in, but for the most part he's actually joining these team fights so far simply because he has to, right? He can't haunt in like Purge talked about earlier. You just cannot chance the fact that they could just global and stop your reality rift.
Yeah, it would really shut things down. If you get caught, if your team gets caught with you not there, even if your ulti gets casted, it's just
and the worst thing is your team thinks you can be there, but you can't.
Yeah. They're like, okay, here comes Spectre. Things are going to be fine. They fight. Hopefully you can communicate it over team chat. Fingers crossed. It's a Yasha.
So first Yasha adjustment the of the build. I mean, there's a Yasha on Spectre. There's no Sainz on Doom.
No, it's not a Yasha on Spectre. It's a Yasha on the Juggernaut. Excuse me.
Okay.
So could still be Diffusal. It better be Diffusal. Diffusal's so good on Spectre compared to a Yasha. Yasha's not bad, but I think the Diffusal Blade will be way better.
I mean, I think Yasha help you far more. The only argument for you to get Diffusal this game is that you could purge off the Surge. And that's a pretty big deal, because a lot of time Darkstar players are like, oh, I'll wait for him to get low, and then I'll Surge him away. And you're like, nope. So
yeah, any time that they end up saving a kill can really delay things, make things a lot harder.
Well, both team is farming up and gearing for late games. Dire is doing a very good job stacking this ancient time. This is like the second or third time I've seen him stacking it. Whose helm is actually that? Is that? Yeah, that's Jarrow's helm.
I see that on him.
And they're getting a ton of work there in the ancients. Meanwhile, nobody's stacking the ancients on the Radiant side or any part of jungle. So if this game goes long, Vichy Gaming is going to lose out in terms of a farm war, if you will.
They're still actually jungling pretty well, though. Most of their team is actually at the bottom. The SMG does have his Diffusal Blade finished, so they're going to be ready to fight at this point. 1,157 HP. And CTY is also quite farmed still. A lot of Diffusal Blades. A lot of Shadow Blades in this game, actually. So he's actually TPing top. So this is one thing. I'm sorry, this is actually CTY going. X is being used. Willy Torrent as well. Here comes the Torrent. Here comes the boat. Ooh. Possibly BKB's popped. He actually wants to fight this. So
he wants
one
the tower.
BKB charge. He does get the tower. Nice play there. Black Cannon helping out. Global Silence as well. They're going to be fighting mid. Two towers go down. Doom takes the tower, but he is being chased. Diffusal Blade slows him by so much. Easy kill there. And a Doom on Jug. Wow, they're going all the way for clock. Are they really going to dive this? This seems like quite the dive to me. I don't know about you.
ZSMJ is... I mean, there's a Haste of Kunkka, right? In fact, there's no BKB up on... I see. If you get a Torn and you get a kill with the boat, that's a big one right now. In fact, no!
Oh, wow.
What a rare miss. They will find Kabu. They will kill Kabu. And it's going right now on IC. IC trying to fight his way out. You're not going to get that one. The Purge is going to come through. Yep. That's going to be a free kill. And Vichy Gaming takes him off a big advantage. Blam! Going just a drive-by, but he's going to get pick off CTY running low. He's going to run back out. And that's yet another free one. The Healing Ward is going to try its best to bring everybody back out. Unfortunately, Duration ran out. They just got, what, 6-7 kills out of that?
They got a lot of kills. Even with the Mist Torrent combo, they still were able to pick off the enemy heroes. So it helps to have a Shadow Demon in the last track. Anybody that's out of position disrupted into Split Earth, so...
Yeah, that was a very poor play by Rattlesnake. They lost two or three heroes already, and then without BKB, Jarrow was looking to defend a tier 2. There was no way he could defend anything. I'm surprised that Vichy Gaming, I guess they're not high HP enough to kind of steal this ancient camp. But they drop a Sentry Ward, so they'll see it whenever it's being taken, and I think they should actually heal up and look to challenge the attempt there, because they just want a big team fight. They will have bigger items. 2,500 gold on Kunkka, I imagine it's going to be going towards BKB. And then Spectre. ZSMJ love to upgrade his Diffusal Blade. He could do so right now or pick up a Vid Booster. And Juggernaut, he's going to have his Mantle Spell go very soon.
He could actually just upgrade his Diffusal Blade. It's not like they have to worry about an Omni-Knight this game, so I think they definitely could just upgrade it if he wants
Ooh,
to.
Ooh, look at this. Sneak into straight Roche.
Ooh. We don't see this that often by most teams at the moment. Sneak in. They usually just take a tactical advantage, but they're going to be able to finish this one way before the Radiant team gets there, so no threat at all for them getting caught.
Yeah, the Alpha Wolf aura being taken up. I call him Alpha Wolf, but apparently he's the pack leader's aura on Doombringers, allowing him to do a ton more damage output.
That is correct. He can crit now. Gyro picks up the Aegis. They're going to shoot a rocket out, and the Radiant team's not even close. So, yeah, not a big loss for each team, maybe.
They even get themselves a big Ancient Stack for boot. I feel like even though they're losing a team fight, the gold chart's going to swing drastically downwards. Yeah. Dire is right back in this game.
Wow, EXP really jumping Radiant, and then Gold jumping moderately Radiant, or a little bit Radiant as well.
Well,
pretty close based on stats, but that does not mean that they will win, necessarily. Just because they have more money. That's
Damn
what I'm trying
purge.
To say. It was just really, really slow. I'm so fucking tired. You have no idea.
I'm sorry, that was just... Any case, Eagle Song's gonna get picked up by Icy. I mean, I think Ali was talking this... couple times during his cast, as well as during the analyst. I'm personally not a big fan of this the build that he's going for, BKB home into Butterfly and then back to Satanic. It's a nice survival build. It's a very well-rounded build all around, but it just doesn't feel like it's enough damage output against the Spectre, but more importantly against the Koko Rum Kunkka. You need to burst him down quick.
How would you change it though? I mean, because you have to get the BKB. He would have died already at least one time if he didn't have BKB.
I would get the same build so far, but I would have gone for MKB myself.
You would go MKB instead of
Butterfly. I feel like the Butterfly might be a little bit better item choice later on.
Do you really think MKB is that much better though? It's plus 88 damage. It gives 15% attack speed, which is meager. Butterfly gives 60 damage and 60 attack speed, so your DPS is going to be way higher with a Butterfly, if I'm not incorrect. What? Oh, the Doom. What about the Doom Aura?
That's another really good point.
So since you get 30 extra Agi,
I'm not sure if people heard Aoi, so we should replete what he said.
So basically, the Pack Leader's Aura gives you 30% bonus damage. This is based on your primary number, which is only buffed by Butterfly. But not by a huge amount. It's a buff by 30, so basically as you do the math.
30% of 30 is 9. Is that really a big deal?
It's a fair point, but it's a small number. But regardless, Butterfly should give you a lot more DPS to the targets that you're not targeting straight on. Like the MKB proc is only going to apply to the guy that you right-click on directly, so I think it's better in an AoE, not to mention the survivability is there completely. So.
Yeah, the survivability is the kind of the bigger draw here, which I'm not against. Yeah, Spectre against Spectre Kunkka, that's definitely a big deal as well. And looks like he's got to be very careful. I see he's playing very far ahead because he got the Aegis and the BKB, and he's trying to set up a bait for the team. Meanwhile, though, CTY on the bright side, he's going for big creeps. And if he gets Doom right here, he is going to get Doom. But where's the follow-up? They need a rocket. They need a hook. The call-down, it's going to miss as well. The Haunt's going to come through. The call-down clips. The global comes down as well. You got to kill CTY. Where the hell's the disruptor? Has not been a disrupt. But looks like they're going to fight this right now. Where's the vacuum coming in? Icy's going to blow away his Aegis. And there's a buyback. Uh-oh. This could turn very ugly.
Here comes the boat. Perfect torrent on top of
my
Gyro.
God.
Gyro was down immediately. I think he even popped his BKB. He did, but he still dies. The gem is on the ground somewhere. Great split earth as well. Silencer is going to drop, and even Darkseer running for his life. Cogs on the high ground is going to guarantee Clockwork escapes, but Darkseer falls, and a lot of dead
heroes.
Does
it guarantee it? CTY says, man, I want your money. Unfortunately, he's guessing the wrong way. He's going to kill us. And what a buyback into an immediate perfect combo against... I would not have gone for that Torn. Like, he's like, oh my god.
That was
he's got BKB,
ridiculously
right?
Perfect Torn.
Generally, you say, hey... After responding from Aegis, he could spam his BKB quicker than like Torn could land on time.
Probably, yes. It's difficult. The activation time of BKB is instant, basically. So if he really wanted to use BKB immediately, he would have. But I think he maybe overestimated what was going to happen.
He's like, I could see the boat coming, and then I could, you know, block it.
Yeah, he's like, it's going to be fine. I'll maybe save it. And that's fair. You don't always want to pop stuff immediately, because sometimes getting a couple extra seconds out of a team fight will make the difference, because your BKB is going to last longer later, especially in some cases where you don't even need it. If you can just save that thing until you know for sure that a stun's coming, it can really swing fights. Pay off long term.
Yeah, I mean, I heard you guys completely talk about CTY, how he's an awesome player. I wasn't completely sold, and this Kunkka game has definitely kind of opened my eyes in terms of how good this player really is. He's just landing a lot of prediction torrents. That one just completely blew my mind, and now they're completely ahead. They took away the Aegis. It didn't matter. It was two lives on Gyrocopter. They did defend their tier 2, and it. I feel like this one's still everybody's game. That's just definitely our closest game out of all three.
Yeah, that's true.
On both sides. We saw how powerful that initiation power from the Doom is. And if CTY didn't have buyback, or if they weren't fighting that near that tier 2, that would have been a big victory for Rattlesnake.
Well, the game could still go a lot of different ways, like you said. The Kunkka has opted for Daedalus, or at least he's working towards one. Once he grabs that, then there's a whole lot more chance coming to the team fights, because if you can just get lucky and crit on the one Tidebringer hit, you can end up splashing everybody on the enemy team for like 500 plus damage, which is a huge amount. And we should be maybe even seeing updated crit totals. No, we had a PA earlier, so I'm sure the PA is probably what the biggest crits are. I forgot about that.
Oh my god.
Compendium. Everybody's off. Who was expecting a PA, seriously?
I failed.
I thought for sure it'd be like a Kunkka Daedalus or something that would set the crit total, but I saw 1200s and stuff, and that was without a rapier, so.
I guess a very low crit total myself. I was like 800, because it's like, oh, you only have Prophet Daedalus or a CK crits.
Oh, CK crits.
And Juggernaut crits. But damn, well, PA. fucking work.
Yep, we lost.
Yep.
We lost so much. They are, wow, mega retreating here. Are they expecting a push or something?
No, they're going to go back and smoke up right now and try to find somebody.
It's a really inefficient use of walking. They were
I'm
so
not
close.
Sure why FY is leading that charge. Maybe he's actually just scouting here for the Kunkka.
Hmm. No new items for Doom just yet. He has it level 16, though. Still has more gold, and they are pinging higher end.
Yeah, they have ward there, so they see. This is a lot smarter in terms of what they're doing. ZSMJ. Actually, you self-purge silence off of you?
I am not sure. You might be able to, though.
We'll see. Both teams are smoked up right now. The Han's going to come in. Where's the global? No global just yet. They do global. Has he relocated? And that's a bigger question. Yes, he has a vacuum. The wall. The Doom is on. Oh, got to kill that ward. They do. Actually, Luo's taking too much damage right now. He's only got 3 armor. He has to back off the Clockwork Hook. I think he missed it. So does the call down. Just a ton of back and forth. And only Juggernaut died to the Doom, I guess.
That was weird. Torrent's actually going to whiff here. Very rare Torrent miss for CTY
thanks
here.
To ya.
But there was a lot of stuff popped, actually. All of the ulties for Rattlesnake, except for the Clockwork, actually, were used up. Radiant Team saved some of theirs. Juggernaut ends up dying. But now he's got Omni Slash, and they can push this now. They still have Bode. Like, Bode's pretty much going to be up for every fight, just about.
Yep. So. And that's kind of the big difference between the Rattlesnake side and VG Gaming side. All the ultimates on the Dire side are very long cooldown, save for the cooldown. Cooldown has fairly short cooldown as well. They could actually just break mega team fight right now. CTY, again, he's just invis up, looking for a pick, just looking for an X target. I can't find anybody just yet.
There is the, what is it even called? Diabolic Edict going high ground now. A lot of damage being done to the tower. They have Shadowblade, great plate mail on Doom as well. That'll give him some nice survivability, but Vitality Booster on the, up on the Spectre, and especially with the Healing Ward on the low ground, that's going to keep these guys all max HP. The Hookshot's going to completely whiff. I can't believe it. He wanted to go in on the Leshrac. There's a last word. Here comes the boat as well. There's the buff. Their bodies are all shiny now as the missile comes in, but the Cog's doing a great job keeping them low ground. And actually, this puts them in a bad spot because now Kunkka is pretty much out of mana. He can't actually combo in the upcoming fight, and that's going to limit his usefulness by a lot.
Yeah, I think they should back off, to be completely honest. Kunkka, I mean, he still have a bolt or two torrents, depending how he wants it. But the ultimates are starting to come off cooldown here from Rattlesnake as well. Doom's going to be back up relatively soon. And Silencer Global is going to be up soon as well. I don't think you want to take this fight, but they say we're the stronger team. Let's take it.
And again, they do a defensive cogs. Black Cannon's going to be able to break the rest of the creeps, and the missile's also getting cleared. But the tower's so low, they're going to right-click it. I think they will get it. Yep, they got it. Spectre's got the right-click. Vacuum goes in. Wall only catches one, actually, but they do use Haunt. Boat comes through. Another Doom on top of Juggernaut to prevent him from Omni-slashing, at least for a moment of time. Darksteer trying to escape. Oh, man, the Defusal Blade perfectly being used there as soon as the Surge was casted on him. And Spectre actually does go back in. He's got to be careful, though. He's maybe taking some Desolate damage. CTY is going to go down as well, trying to finish off the Doomringer. He's getting really low. The Healing Ward's keeping everybody alive. The only person that died there was CTY. And they will be able to take the Melee Racks, I believe. Do we have enough 5x? Good game is called from Rattlesnake. And Vici Gaming takes it 2-1.
Wow. I did not, again, expect one team fight into a GG, but High Ground was breached. I don't think they could win these team fights. It looked, again, I wasn't sure how they won it because it looked very dicey. Every ultimate was up. The vacuum was nice, but I think the big factor in this team fight is after they vacuum, they just run.
Yeah.
There's no cogs to slow them down. There's no Shiva's guard to call down. If you call down and then vacuum them for a slow, that would be a big thing, but there was nothing.
Yeah, was it bad coordination? I mean, I would say it's at least partially their heroes.
Sure.
Their disables were pretty weak. Call down vacuum would have been fantastic, or like call down vacuum hookshot into a cogs would have been great, but they didn't really have the best initiator, I feel like. They had vacuum, but they didn't have like a good AoE stun to
follow. Well, they had Clockwork Hook, but he never got that 2-3 man cog to start off that team fight. If
yep,
they have,
true.
I feel like the team fight goes a lot better. Also, a lot of times, every single team fight, Doom just like manned up, walked in BKB Scourge Earth, and they just like, well, we just run.
But that's all he does. He can Doom
Spectre, guy. Spectre just went to the back line and started killing stuff.
Yeah, he would like Doom the Juggernaut to prevent an Omni Slash, but Juggernaut wasn't even that farmed. He just had like a Manta and a Phase Boots. It's not that much.
Yep.
Maybe he should have Doomed somebody else. Even like one of the supports, I feel like, might have been more useful. Like Leshrac, if you bring that AoE stun on the team fight, maybe that would have done more. It's hard to say. Was the Doom pick really worth it? I'm not sure. Let's kick it over to the analytics desk with AY2000 and Gods.
I thought the Doom pick was cool. Last fight didn't really work out too well. It seemed to decide everything. Doom the Juggernaut. Juggernaut had already actually dropped the Healing Ward, which was basically what Juggernaut's all about in that fight.
Stayed alive the entire fight and just healed everyone.
Juggernaut took no damage. it was a bit of a disaster. You had the hookshot missing and everything.
That last push was actually pretty clever because the only initiation that Rattlesnake had was a Clockwork Hook, really.
Yeah.
Like, running in a vacuum is okay, but usually you'll catch like 2-3 max, whereas they really need a really big vacuum wall in order to win that. So as long as Clockwork Hook was CD, they could just sort of beat on the tower. As long as they're not like overextending past it, they should have been fine.
All in all, I mean, Rattlesnake, once again, this time they didn't go with their classic dual lanes. They had an unconventional tri lane, the Darkseer, Silencer, and Clockwork. No, sorry. It was Clockwork was mid. Darkseer, Silencer, Gyrocopter. Yeah.
That's the first time I've seen that. I mean, I thought they were actually going to do what Lumi said, where he gets a fast level 2 and they dive him.
Yeah.
But the creep scout thing was actually pretty clever. I just wish that... I don't even know if they could have played more aggressively because, like, Spectre played pretty smart. She, like, pulled it into a tower and then sort of sat in the trees. You always have that dagger to get out into the trees. So... I mean, maybe you would have killed the Leshrac.
Once the supports... Once Rattlesnake got some levels, that Shadow Demon rotated from mid.
I thought that was really smart, too. And then CTY got a solo kill on the Clockwork, which is pretty cool. He faked him out with the Torrent, which was nice.
It was still some questionable play from
The Clockwork got a solo kill back, which...
Both was questionable plays in my mind, but... Well,
I don't know. Sometimes, stuff just happens, right? Like, he didn't even mean to cog him. I'm pretty sure it's just like, oh, let's go for a mana burn.
Yeah.
And then C2Y comes from, like, 300 range and just...
He got some RNG luck with the battery assault as well. There was creeps around and it was hitting him almost every single time. But
that was pretty nice. Like, it was a good reaction by a Clockwork to just turn on battery assault and just beat on. It's like, oh, I can kill this guy.
So Spectre seems to be the new Vici Gaming top carry pick?
Yeah, it looks like it. I really want to see how they deal with a really strong aggressive trialing, because that's what sort of I've seen teams have trouble with. I remember there's a Spectre game that got picked versus IG, and the Spectre had like 7 CS at like 12 minutes or something.
Yeah.
They just ran an absurdly strong trialing, like with Lina or something in there. So I want to see how they deal with that, because there would definitely be something to learn. Because VG, they're looking really good, and I'm excited to see them go against LGD. I think they'll both try to pick Spectre.
Yeah, speaking of Vici Gaming versus LGD, that's going to be our next coming up match. We can take a quick look at the bracket now to see where things lie now. Well, here's our schedule. Our last match of today, it's Vici Gaming up against LGD. That match taking place in about 10 minutes' time, as you can see in our schedule. As for the brackets, well, two teams have dropped down to the loser brackets. Two teams are here in our winner bracket final, essentially. LGD China versus Vici Gaming. The winner of this match is guaranteed a trip to Seattle. They're guaranteed a place in the grand finals. Either they're playing directly in the international, or they'll be playing in that wild card match up against DD Dota. So a really high stakes match here, which we're going to have coming up. LGD Vici Gaming, I can't wait for it. And I think that pretty much sums up our previous game analysis. We'll be taking a quick break, guys. When we come back, we'll be looking to introduce our next and final match of today. See you guys soon.